What is going on, everybody? You have found your way to the Manic Diecast channel, aka John Hunt's Hot Wheels, or whatever other name I decide to change it to within the next couple of days because I get tired of them. Anyway, I'm on my way to a Dollar General. Today's hunts are going to, hopefully we can find some premiums, some treasure hunts, maybe some good main lines. I mean, we all kind of go after treasure hunts, don't we? That's kind of the whole name of the game. I do like collecting regular main lines too, though. I am driving, but I do have my eyes and focus completely on the road. I'm just talking to myself with the camera pointed towards me, and it's okay. Anyway, this is not going to be a super long video, which is going to be good for you. I'm going to try to get it down to about 15 minutes. And we're going to be going into some Dollar Generals, some Walmarts, Targets, Ingles Markets. Hopefully we can find a couple things worth taking home. But the name of the game for me, again, is premiums. I love premiums. It's kind of where I'm stuck on buying now. But if we find a couple nice main lines, we obviously pick those up. But we also know that Dollar General doesn't carry those premiums, like the Boulevard series and things like that. So a lot of the time, it's just going to Dollar General, trying to find that one treasure hunt that really catches my eye. Dollar General usually does okay with them. So this has been too long of a video intro. Make sure you stick around, because the next time you see me, we'll be in Dollar General. Stick around, have fun, happy Monday, and let's get this thing going. Peace.
See what we can find other than a whole big bucket of nothing. I do like that car, but not enough to buy it. Let's see here. Anything? Well, looks like the same stuff as it was last week. Some dump bin stuff. Let me get an idea here. I might have to put y'all down for a minute just to see. We're getting LK stuff, so I'm gonna put you guys down for a minute, and I'll come back with something if I find something. So be right back.
All right, guys. Well, that Walmart was a bust, and it has been for the past at least month. It's been really dry. What the heck? It's been really dry, and you know, coming this far out is almost worthless. But as you could see in that last clip, it was the same stuff that I saw last week, which was just a bunch of garbage. Stuff that I already had, stuff that I don't want, and obviously, you know, no treasure hunts or anything like that. So we're gonna go to a couple more Dollar Generals, at least one that I know usually has decent stuff, and hit up another Walmart, and yeah, basically see what happens. I did just get an alert on my car saying that my key battery is low, so I'm probably gonna have to go and figure that out. That's a lot of fun, and I'm sure it's not gonna be cheap. So wish me luck, and we'll see you at the next one.
All right, guys. We're at this Dollar General here. There's a box that's kept open. Looks like it's already been gone through. At it. Okay, case. Just a lot of X business. And I'm making a mess, but we'll clean it up in a minute. We'll see if we can't find something decent. So I can get a better view of what we got here. Okay, we'll work through that. And okay. I'll be right back. I'm gonna clean this up.
Alright guys. Well, that Dollar General was a bust. I did put the split cut in half case. I put it back together and set it back on the top of the shelf where it was supposed to go, but some other collector got to it first. Shelves were full. It's all K case, but nothing that I found was worth anything to me, which seems to be kind of the problem. So now I'm on my way to a Walmart, the second Walmart. And before that Dollar General, I also...
We are at Walmart right now, seeing what their stock is. And I only come to these stores once a week, so we'll see what happens. I don't know. But we'll find something eventually. So here we go. All right. So let's focus in. Let's focus in again. All right, a lot to unpack here. Let's come down here and see premium wise, see what they got. Literally a whole lot of nothing. Oh, look at that. A couple of Fast and the Furious, Jurassic World. I don't really care about the, I mean, it looks cool, but I'm not really impressed, so I'll keep that on the pegs for somebody else. Let's go back over here. Why is my camera not focusing in, man? Alright, let's check some dump bins and see what we can find. Probably nothing, if I were to guess. Just a bunch of bent cars and just mess. We're going to go through some of these, and I will update you guys if I find something. So, we'll be right back. Okay, guys, so I did find some more premiums on the other side. Oh, that's neat. Muscle machines. I don't know anything about those cars, though, so. Now, I'd really like to find a chase car. I got that guy. Where's the... Is this all the same car? It looks like it. 3, 4, yeah, it's all the same. Uh-oh, it's all the same stuff, but, you know, it's just bust after bust after bust. No chase, okay. Sprites, I mean, you might get lucky, but typically I don't. So, I mean, what can you do, honestly? Just keep trying. And I don't know enough about them too. I'm going to have to start doing my homework on these. Some Johnny Lightnings. I do know that sometimes the greenies, or whatever you want to call them, are super hard to find. But, you know, if they got green wheels or some shit, like some crap like that, you know you got something good. But typically speaking, I never have that luck. Oh, that's pretty neat. Save that, I'm not going to get it. Some bootleggers, haulers, and again, I don't know, what's the deal with this guy? That looks pretty dope, but I don't know if it, would that be a chase? I don't know. Comment below, because I don't know anything about these guys. No, it wouldn't be a chase because there's two of them back here, but they do look cool. I will say that. They do look neat, but not a chase, so, and I don't know what they would be anyway, so, yeah, I guess we're done with this store. We're going to go to the next and see if we can't find something there, so, yep, see you at the next one. All right, we're at an Ingles now. This might be familiar. A lot of you guys in the West or whatever typically have a lot of hot wheels in grocery stores, but this is basically what we have. Basically a whole lot of nothing. Jurassic World, Jurassic Park cars, trick-or-treat stuff, or 54th anniversary stuff. And then this is basically where we're at with Hot Wheels in our stores. I mean, it's pretty sad. But, it's not good. So we're gonna see if we can't find another spot where Hot Wheels might be. Go from there, so hold tight. Okay, guys, so we found one over here, but it seems to be, oh, look at this, that's a good error. Look at that. Oh wait, no, it's tape, guys, never mind, not an error car. That would have been super dope if it was, but it's not. So we go through and see if there's anything worth picking up. It looks like it's all old, you know, case stuff. Never can be too sure, so we'll just check it out. It looks like a bunch of new stuff, so alright, check out another couple areas while I'm down. They kind of hold them right over here. And there's some mountain drifter stuff up there, stuff that I already have. But yeah, not a whole lot here, guys, so I suppose we'll go on to the next one. So yeah. Another bust. So, yep, we'll go to the next one. See ya.
All right, folks. So, that's store number. Honestly, I don't even know what store number that is. I think 5. And we're still empty-handed. This is kind of the reality of Hot Wheels hunting, especially where I'm located in North Carolina. Location varies everywhere. But I'm not fully convinced that some of the YouTubers that do Hot Wheel hunting videos actually find what they find. This is an unpopular opinion, but I'm kind of in the idea that, you know, sometimes they'll bring cars with them, treasure hunts and so on and so forth, to plant and then reveal. Now, I could be wrong, and I hope I'm wrong, but I don't know, it's weird. You know, I'm always rejected whenever I ask about cases, if they have any Hot Wheels in the back or something. The times that they said yes, they also said that it's against company policy to bring them out for customers to open, that they have to open it themselves. So it also begs the question, you know, some of these hunters that are out here opening cases after cases after cases, kind of makes you wonder. Obviously they know people, and I'm not trying to bash anybody here, guys. I'm just trying to vent my hunting frustrations, but it is kind of weird. But we're on to another Dollar General. We're going
right another Dollar General here, and as per usual, not a whole lot going on. We'll go through them real quick and see. Yeah. here, so we're gonna go with the next one and see what we got.
Alright, so we're in an Ingles now. We're gonna try. I think this will be my last stop, and then I gotta get my key fob figured out. But I think, if I remember correctly, of course, I'm not really sure. I know they had cases here last week when I came, but, oh yeah, they're over here. It's probably gonna be the same stuff, but we'll see if we can't find something worth taking home. So yeah, we'll see what we got.
Okay, so got decent premiums here. Some Matchbox, got the Mountain Drifters, got that one. I'm gonna have to put some of these over here for a minute, guys. 4 or 5, 5 or 5. They got the Leno's Garage stuff, which is neat. We got some of this stuff. I'll move that back. No chase cars. Bugatti. I got that one already. I don't need another one. So we're going to slide these back up here. Put those there and we'll check. Got B case, which isn't bad. That's a pretty cool bone shaker. Obviously, for recolor the Glory Chaser, it didn't really give you a good view of that one, but you can take my word for it. The Scorcher. I always thought that was would have been a cool treasure hunt, but it's not, so not a whole lot happening over here. It's weird, but I like that focus there. But I do like that Chevelle. It's a pretty nice Chevelle. So, I might be getting that. Let me check over here. I'm going to update you guys if I find anything. But, this is what we're working with here. And I'll update you guys here in just a second.
Alright, well, this is the 6th store, and I have come up with a goose egg. So, I'm going to take a break. I'm going to get this key fob battery changed out. And I might go to, the old Target. I don't know yet, but I'll be back with you at the next store and not the key fob place because that's anticlimactic, much like these hunts. So hopefully luck will turn around and we'll find something good. So I'll see you at the next store. All right, guys, we are at a Walmart, and just for kind of a little context of what Hot Wheels hunting is like here in my area, this Walmart is always an absolute bust. So hopefully I'll be surprised with you guys, but I just know I won't be. Also, the key fob is gonna have to be completely replaced. Unfortunately, batteries did not fix the issue. So that's gonna be about $400. So that's gonna be super fun. So I can tell you right now already, I hadn't even gotten to the aisle yet, but this is going to be a nightmare of nightmares. So, oh my God, check it out. This is it. It's been this way for 3 months, maybe more. And if you come down here, it's just a joke. Like, I mean, at some point they gotta restock, right? At some point. I mean, this is just what it's been for the longest time. They're restocking Hot Wheels fingerboards, but no actual Hot Wheels, unfortunately. So, oh well, we'll stop at a Target and go home. See you at the next one.
This is what we got. Got some main lines over here. Oh, we got some Ronin. No kidding. Okay, well, finally got some Ronins here. Beautiful freaking work. Well, you know I'm getting all of them because I got to now. I got to. That's the rules, right? No chases though, but it's okay because look. We got all of them. 1, 2, 3, four, where's five? We're missing five. No, there it is right there. Oh man, look at that thing. Whew. Show you a view, boys and girls. Man, all day, all freaking day, and we finally found something we could use. Whew. Man, that's good. And I'm only getting what I need. I don't need all the extras. If they had a chase, it'd be cool, but let's see what they have on the pegs. Probably nothing, but we'll see. So, well, at least we found the runs, so that's good. I will look through the pegs real quick and see what else I find. Probably nothing from the treasure hunts, but I keep forgetting what case. That's B case. Okay. I'll get back with you in a minute. Just look at all these Batmobiles, guys. They're literally everywhere. Just one after another. Not a super or nothing. But we got our Ronin runs, guys. Finally. Alright. We can rest easy now, guys. Came down here to look at the rest. Didn't find anything, so we'll call this store a win and go down to the next one. Actually, I think we might be done. So, see you guys at the next one. Alright, so Target was an actual success. Thanks, Target. You guys are awesome. I've never seen that amount of premiums there before, so that was kind of fun. I'm pretty sure that is going to be the last, my car's over here, that is going to be the last one for the day. The next time you see me, we'll be doing the quick, you know, the haul, the post-hunt haul, and take a look at the Ronins up close where we're not inundated with people and screaming kids. So, also still kind of interesting to see so many Batmobiles on the shelves. So anyway, we'll see you guys at the house when we do the unboxing or unbagging the post haul. Wow, my hair is gray. Anyway, see you soon. All right, guys, we are back home. It's been a very long day of hunting, but we were able to score something worth bringing home and buying. And just to make this exit portion of the video a little bit quicker, we scored all the Ronin runs, which I've been looking for high and low. And I do understand that they don't get released at the same time in every place, but we're going to go over them, starting with number one of five, the 95 Mazda RX-7. I absolutely love that casting. It just looks good. It makes me happy, as it should make you happy. This is no particular order. This is the four of five. This is a 98 Subaru Impreza. Absolutely beautiful. It is the 22B STI version. It just looks good. I mean, I don't know if you can see all that, but I'm just moving around. I'm not taking up all your time. I don't want this to be an hour long video. And this right here, this little fella, the RX-7 S or FC Pandem. Beautiful car, absolutely beautiful. I was really surprised to even see these on the shelves, but once I did, it looked like three cases had come in because I was able to get a case. This right here is the 300ZX Twin Turbo. Absolutely love it. One of my neighbors had this exact same car. Beautiful car, fun to drive in real life. The fact that they made a car out of this for the premium car culture, Ronin Run, really does kind of make me happy as well. And the third, which I think this is pretty cool, the 81 Toyota Starlet KP61. This is a really good one, and I really enjoy the casting. It's tiny, the wheels are super tiny. It just looks good. Now, I did notice that for whatever reason, I am missing I'm not.
No, I'm not. I'm just dumb. Anyway, this is the entire Ronin Run series. And I couldn't, honestly, guys, I couldn't be happier with these guys. I love, and I kind of, my collection is more geared towards premiums, mainly because I just like the way they look. I think they look a little bit better. Obviously, Treasure Hunts and Supers are super awesome. But at the same time, Ronin Run 2023 getting started off pretty fantastically. Anyway, guys, it's going to end this video. I hope you guys at least do me the solid favor of at least hitting the like button, comment, share, subscribe if you feel so inclined. You don't have to, but it is free, just so you know. Anyway, this video is going to be probably long, so I apologize. Every Monday, we hunt. So usually every Monday afternoon or Tuesday afternoon, the video gets uploaded. The quality will get better. Just bear with me. Much love, guys. Happy hunting out there, and make sure you leave enough for the next guy. Later.